What's up, guys? It's Daz here. But you don't really care as we are back in the jungle. We have done everything else there is to do right now. We have gone through all of the levels and done all the rank B, A, and already obviously C ranks for every level. So let's make some progress on the story. Last time, we jumped off of the egg carrier to reach Eggman. And, well, he's still running around somewhere. Who knows what he's doing? And something I would like to point out, though, is if you come around here, it's a nice little view. You can see, like, it's very 2D, but you can see the rest of the, the river. You've got more forest and a mountain in the back. I think, actually, you might even see that in the teaser trailer slash title sequence of the game, which is kind of cool. But anyway, don't matter. We are going into the temple because a fairy led us here. Who knows who that fairy is? It don't matter. Let's go through. Wait, is there a hole at the bottom I'm supposed to fall in? No, we're fine. Okay, cool. Welcome to Sonic Lost World. Go to the center of the ruins. Not to be confused with Sonic Lost World, the somewhat relevantly new modern Sonic game with those people with really demonic dialogue lines that turned out to be surprisingly bland in the end, even though I guess it's an okay game, but that's about it. Just okay. So the theme here, you may notice, you may not, is snakes. We're running through a snake right now. It's like one big body sort of thing. Or at least it's supposed to be a serpentinian thing. It's interesting. This is something that Sonic's never really... He's gone through these kind of temples before, but it's very out of tone with the rest of this game. Maybe there's a secret we're soon to find out. Anyway, this is the only stage in Sonic Adventure, and Sonic Adventure DX, obviously, that only two players, or two characters, can access.
Press the three hidden switches in the room to open the front door.
Usually, there's three characters that go into every level, but this one only has Sonic and one other one.
Press this switch to raise the water level.
And the whole point of this puzzle is it's one big room. There is a water level that constantly rises as you go up the room by pressing the buttons, and there's a big stone snake spinning around the center who eventually, when he gets over here, becomes the platform. You use him to ride along and get to the next level higher up and so on and so on. As you climb, you make the water go higher, the snake gets flying or swims higher up and you can get further along. I don't remember the snake being this jittery, so I think it might actually just be the steam port. I mean, people do say it's pretty bad, so... oh well. Now here is the first of three switches. With all three switches, you can get through the door. So basically, get on every platform and you should get what you need to get. So, press this switch. Water level goes up a little more, which is always helpful. Now, I have two other pieces of trivia notes about this level, but honestly... can't really mention them. The other one mentions the other character's name, and I'll come to it when we get to that point. The other one talks about the end of the level and what there is to be discovered, so really, I haven't got much else to say. But I will say this is really cool. I like the concept. It's this weird, like, you know something... oh dear. Okay, cool. Jumping high enough. You know something's going on here, and it's like, something's up. We're about to find out this big secret. Because maybe Eggman isn't our true enemy. Who knows? Is that where we're supposed to go? No, this is just a couple power-ups. What? Huh? I think I've messed something up along here. Because that's down. That's underwater, so obviously we don't need to go to that bit anymore, but... something's going on. Have we done this? Yeah. No. Oh, shoot. I might have royally screwed up. This is the bottom. Oh, okay.
Press this switch to raise the water level.
I think that would be lowering it at this point. Okay. There we go. We're back on the snake. This is gonna be a big trouble if this happens when we're trying to do this fast. This snake is like a make or break snake at the third level of this. Okay, we've been there, we just came from there. What? Here? No? We were there as well. Shoot, am I missing a platform? Hold on. Let me work this out. I wanna be up there. We can't get there yet. That's useless. Okay, I guess we have to... oh, I see. Okay, I guess I figured this was just the end of the road, or that we'd already done this bit. We didn't. We have to climb, like, back under and over itself to get to here. Yeah, there we go. Hit this button. Yeah, okay. Alright, I got you now. Follow the snake, and it should take us to the next platform we want. This is kind of, although very jittery and before its time, this is kind of Shadow of the Colossus-y. Like, you're on a big beast swimming around. I don't know. We did not hit all those buttons. Okay, great. What's this way? That's just a power-up. We've missed... well, there was that platform we didn't touch that was in the distance. I just assumed we'd already done it. Hold on. Okay. Orbinaut, get at it. Orbinaut! How did you do that? Okay, now I might have really screwed up. We're in some real deep water. Shoot. Okay, this is more platform. Get me out of the water. I don't know if that counted, really. Get me on this. Oh, okay, good. Breath is back. And... oh, okay. Oh, no. There we go. Okay. Button. That is where we were before, and actually the island we were at was like there, I believe. Yeah. Okay. Whew. That was an effort and a half to work out. And I bumped the mic, which is always great. Okay. This is just one section. This is just one room. This is like the first fifth of the level. It's gonna be like a 25 minute long level. Jesus. Please no. We'll see. Okay, just come along here. The door should be unlocked now, I believe. Yeah. Alright, now things are getting serious. The world is green. Oh, maybe that's just my color blindness. Maybe it's just supposed to be dusk. I don't know. I guess that makes sense. We came in at daytime, it could be dusk. So, this place, this room.
Use the mirror to help guide you.
It's very dark, so you want to reflect the light about to make you able to see. Even though it doesn't make more light, it just reflects it otherwise, so the light should still just diffuse at the same rate and just see mostly the same amount of darkness. You can't see light in mirrors. But whatever. You sort of know what I was trying to say there, like mirrors don't glow when they're in the dark, but oh well, it would just reflect the lack of light, but whatever. Maybe it's torches. Are those torches? If it is, why don't you just hold one with you? It don't matter. Anyway, it don't matter. That's weird to say in such like a not accent-y way. Right, get on you, get on you. Ba-da, boom. Oh, and it actually lights up the snakes like lanterns. That's kind of cool, actually. I like that. Here's an endless array of arrows coming from nowhere. Now, ancient light. Not ancient light. Well, whatever. Don't matter. Here's another section. Water! We just slide along forever, basically. Well, not forever. It's weird. A lot of these 3D Mario games have these sort of sections towards the end of the game. It's like a big water slide. It's cool. It's fun. I like it. I know this especially appears in the sequel, and I like it a lot. It's cool. As I said, and it's fun. Did I say that bit? Anyway, let's get some pop culture references in here. We're now being chased by a rock. A rock on fire. A rock on fire chasing or getting faster and faster. And it's not done yet. It had a loop to fall down. A loop? What am I saying? It had a platform to fall down, but that doesn't stop it. But unfortunately, you don't actually see it disappear. It just sort of falls down the hole off camera. But oh well. It happens. Right. Does that count as one long room? Maybe two rooms? One the dark one and the other like the slide section? Anyway, up here you can get a shield. I really probably would have preferred the electric one if I could be honest, but oh well. Right. And then next we have... whoops. Get out of here. Right, this room is an interesting room. It's supposed to be a bit of a maze, but I don't know if it's childhood memories or just trial and error, but I know this
in
my heart.
You can walk on those panels when lit.
If you hit this button twice... no, three times then? It will make it for you. I'm not sure if you're supposed to do that. Maybe you're only supposed to press one and then another one, but either way, that's how I've always done it. Press that button multiple times until it works. I think that's what I did the first time I played as a kid. I was like, oh, it didn't work. Let me press it again. What you do is you move the panels. They light up when they make a path, and you can use it as gravity. Truly the first Super Mario Galaxy game. It's cool, because this is like the first time that the Sonic team did like proper 3D platforming. This is the first 3D Sonic game proper. And the platforming mechanics they've added is interesting to look at, you know? They've got gravity-defying stuff. They've got panels that flicker, boxes that spin. They got all sorts like enemies that make the path. It's quite inventive, you know? Very creative. I like it. Yeah, like, I can see how this marked quite an era in how people say it's such a beloved game, because it really did add a lot to the Sonic franchise, because it's doing everything for the first time. And sure, Mario probably did it first. In fact, it most certainly did. They were like a whole console ahead. Maybe not, but you know, they were somewhat, you know, close together. And it's just nice to see it all turn out. Anyway, this music,
yes,
at the very end, appears elsewhere. That's all I'll say for that trivia. So we'll just leave it at that. Now, let's see what happens next. This was a big temple. I don't remember it being this big,
yeah,
in the field.
Not bad.
That took us 9.5 minutes. That's not... No, that's pretty bad. If you're a fan of the sequel, you might recognize those wall patterns.
Wow, what's this? A mural. What's this place? Where am I? This is really weird.
You'll see a temple on fire and the Master Emerald. Okay. Oh, hello. Hello?
Why? Why did this have to happen? It's terrible. I must stop this now!
What was that all about? I don't think I'm dreaming here. Hmm? Eggman! What's he doing here? Well, never mind. This time I'll get him good!
Alrighty then. Eggman's here. It's dusk. Later on you'll realize that doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but we'll move on anyway. We cannot go back into Sonic Lost World because they always lock a level after you've done it, but now things have changed. We've gone through two time jumps. We went through the level and had a dream sequence thing. So now in that time, Eggman's made a hidden base. In fact, it almost looks like a city or a rocket. Interesting. Well, I haven't really got anywhere else to go, so let's jump on in. Welcome to the hidden base. You'll find in here Silver Sonic 2 is what that's called. An empty tube here. Interesting. And Metal Sonic. Nice little references to some older Sonic games. Now, you come down here, you'll find a big area of nothingness. There is a door, sure, but you can't go through it. Well, I might have literally gone through it there, but that's not what was intended. Maybe that's an area for another character to explore later. Anyway, to progress to the final level, we need this last puzzle here. What you do is you need to get every panel not looking like Eggman. Every button you press changes that button and the buttons around it. I don't actually know how to do this. I usually just experiment until it works, but okay, so you can fix those two. There is a really cool pattern to know this. If you really need it, I'll put it up, but otherwise, I managed to do it accidentally. You can just follow what I do as well. That works too. Anyway, let's If I can get up this hill, there we go. Let's get in to the final egg. Go to the center of the base. Now, at the start, this enemy is called an Egg Keeper. It only appears in the Dreamcast version and later 2010 ports like this one. It doesn't appear in the GameCube version. Why? I don't know. It just does slash doesn't. It's interesting, but oh well. On top of that, an unfinished Duck Badnik was intended for this level, but was removed in the final game. It can be found in pre-release copies, but that's about it. It shoots the player and attempts to run away. It's interesting. I feel like it sounds like another enemy I know, but I couldn't tell you what it was, so I don't know what I'm talking about, but oh well. Now these lasers can be destroyed by destroying the little white pods on the side. They are robots, I guess, after all. Also, the sound effect they use is very reminiscent of Retro Sonic slowing down, which is cool, those Egg Keepers, I mean. So yeah, it's cool. Right, let's jump on through. What do we got next? Got, like, 9 rings over here. I'll take all of them, thank you. Right, does this door open? Of course it doesn't. Alright, I guess we'll find another way in. Let's fly up over, huh? That works. Big open door above it. So, what do you think Eggman's making here? He's got some sort of, like, meshing device. He's got a really long tumble dryer. Ugh. Oh, man. It sort of reminds me of the time I went to, like, a little festival. I can't remember what they call it. Not casino. Carnival! That's the one I'm looking for. And there was, like, these big rooms you'd go in just like this, and I remember I got very scared very quickly because I was worried I'd go upside down, and I hated the thought of being upside down. Even though it was just a path that walked through this room that circled, if that makes sense. So I wasn't actually moving on... I wasn't on the moving platform, I was just on the path of it. Either way, I did not like it. I cried. I was a very upset 6-year-old. 5-year-old? Probably 5, actually, at that point. Anyway, welcome to a new room. This is all one long room. It's a massive corridor cylinder hallway. What you want to do is you want to go down, but you don't want to dive down. Because even though Sonic jumped from the egg carrier onto the Mystic Ruins and landed on his face, he will die if he touches the ground too quickly here, or just goes through the death panels that exist invisibly around this area. Instead, you need to make your way down bit by bit using the platforms that are available. First of all, you can get a 1-up if you go that up. A life if you go that way. We don't need it. We've got 99. We're fine. Here's another one, apparently. Ooh, if I don't get glitched on that rope there. Let's roll down while the screen looks way too blue. And then just hold up for this bit. It really helps do things nice and easy. Now we're on the floor, and that's nice. Yeah, we're not done yet. And not only that, it takes us back up again, which is annoying, but oh well. So just shoot these 3. I fell through. You see, look, I mean, I'm walking down there, but I'm dead. Oh well. Just the way this game works, there's just death panels you cannot avoid. Now hit. Up. Lovely. Jump. Cool. Wait for it. Nice. Boom. Okay. That wall life is forever gone. Hold up and it just sort of does this. It just sort of cycles. It's a bit slow on that bit, which is weird. But I like how the rings are ready for when it goes up the wall there. It's like they clearly tested it and decided they can't fix it, so they just put rings there instead. It's funny to me. Did I say 2 iteration walls? What are iteration walls? 2? Why 2 walls? Why not 4? Oh well. Right, wait for these slowly swinging hammers. I don't know why it reminds me of, like, a Mario game. I don't know which Mario game has swinging hammers in it. I mean, obviously got, like, Paper Mario, where Mario swings his hammer, but maybe, like, Clockland in Mario 64? Clockland. What was that, TikTok Clock? Is that what that's called? Oh, I guess there was the swinging handle there. Maybe that's what I'm thinking of. I don't know. Right, I'm trying to get the timing right so I can get to the platform and dodge the hammer. Okay, that works. I really like the music here, though. It's cool. Yeah, it's good. Right. So go down here with this interesting camera angle. You'll see we can go down this way to the right, but if you go to the left, there is a little secret. It's not that important. Maybe for the later ranks it will be, but it's 15 rings. Always nice for you. Just a nice little tiny secret I actually remember. I generally don't remember many secrets here. I just know the main bit. That's cool. game is kind of long and it's weird. It's weird, mate. It makes it feel short. Why do I keep yawning? It is 2:30 in the afternoon. I don't know why I'm yawning. And I'm not bored either. I'm quite excited, really. We're coming to the end of Sonic Story. This is the final egg. Has to be the final level, right? Yeah. Cool. Of course, me saying that makes it sound like it won't be. Who knows? Maybe it will. Maybe it won't. I guess you'll have to find out. Here's another block of 9 rings. I swear that doesn't happen in any other level. Oh well. I'm going to get that ring. Thank you. Right. If you need a break to get some popcorn, do it now because this transition takes forever. We started at 4:44. Remember that. So if you want a 13-second transition, this is the place to go. Seriously, I could have munched on some Tic Tacs in that time. Some popcorn-flavored Tic Tacs. They do exist as well, actually. My friend works at WH Smith and recently just gave me a massive bulk of slightly out-of-date popcorn-flavored Tic Tacs. It was very odd, but oddly, I enjoyed it, so naturally, I'm constantly buying more. They're at a reduced price, too, so I ain't gonna bother, am I? I ain't gonna mind. Right, there's enemies. Don't know their names, but there's an infinite amount of them. And you can shoot them and... Why do I keep saying shoot? You can homing attack into them and they'll explode. But if you use your speed light dash attack, it's really fun. Look at that. Is that not satisfying to you? Maybe next time I'll wait till there's a big bulk of them and then I'll just use it. It'll be beautiful. I'm going to enjoy it a lot. Right, let's move on. What is next, Eggman? It must be floating fans, of course. Stand above them, and they make you fly. Choose the path carefully, get through. It's nice and easy. Yeah, the camera will agree with me, though. Okay, and then come down here. Beautiful. Bip. Bob. Nice. And then... Whoa, okay, I better use the speed boost. No, that doesn't help me get the items at all either. I have to do it myself? That's some really interesting design. Unless I messed up with the speed boost somehow, like pressing a control stick thing. I don't know, that's weird. Okay, let's fly through. Now, there is another really cool Easter egg coming up real soon. Actually, first, I have to use that ancient move. I keep wanting to call it it's not an ancient attack, is it? It's the light speed dash attack or something. I messed up. Okay, or the game messed up. Let's try this again. Oh, yes! Look at that! How could you not find that fun and entertaining? Good lord! That's crazy! I thought I'd never use that attack again as well. Oh well, right. It's around here we're going to get to a really cool little Easter egg. Let me get all these rings by cheating with my shield. And, oh no, we still got a bit of time. Never mind. I'll point it out when we get to it. When you're falling, and you land on a platform, there's always a break for when you're allowed to jump. And obviously, I landed and I would have had plenty of time to jump. It's because I got that jump boost. Oh, of course, that's not going to allow me to do that. It, like, gave me extra time to land and it wouldn't let me jump again. That's a really bad, bad engine game. I really wish they remastered this game just with, you don't even have to change. I guess it would be good to change the models, but, like, just polish it. That's all I want. A polishing round. I don't even want modern day looking Sonic to be in this game. Just polish how it plays. And maybe the looks a little bit, because it is a Dreamcast game. Whoa, okay. This one's making me sick. Okay, I'm glad that one stopped as soon as it did. Right, here is the Easter egg. You've got an egg keeper and that's all cool. You've got these pawns that I never remember the names of. There's a really cool Easter egg here. This may be the end of one character's level here, but it's only the beginning of Sonic's. It's not. But there's a secret spring, you'll see, off in the distance. Grab a couple animals, get a speed boost. Not a speed boost. I was hoping I could get some sort of ramp running start, but I couldn't find it. Oh, well. Guess there is a one. Get on the spring and... You will find this. Pretty cool, huh? Unfortunately, you can't light-speed dash across the whole thing. It just sort of only goes part of the way, but you ever wanted Sonic in your game while Sonic is in the game? Or something. I don't know how I was trying to phrase that. Very awkwardly is how it turned out. There he is. It's a really cool little Easter egg, but I'm One you don't really see very often in Sonic Caves, I feel. It doesn't happen very often, you know? Right, get out of here. Now that I've got that light speed dash attack, I want to use it all the time. Oh, okay. Well, you two can get out of here, but Sonic, I think you can stick around. Right, let's move on. What's up here? More egg keepers. That's cool. Wow, okay. That was very dramatic. There's something up there, but I can't get to it, I don't think. There's no spring. So, oh well. We'll just ignore it. More light speed dashing, please. And
yes,
this is the end. This is apparently the center of the base.
Yeah, not bad.
Well, if it isn't my pal, Sonic. I'm surprised you made it this far.
Hold it right there, Eggman!
Welcome to the final boss fight of Sonic Story.